Okay, now what we're gonna say here, now that we know how to identify them as weak or strong, let's say we have more than one strong oxyacid. How do we determine which one is even stronger than the other? That's when these two things come into play. We're gonna say when comparing the strengths of different oxyacids, remember, first we have to look at the number of oxygens. We're gonna say the more oxygen, the more acidic. Because you need to meet that two oxygens more requirement. So again, what you do first when comparing oxyacids, the one with more oxygens will be stronger. But let's say that they both have the same number of oxygens. What's the second factor we can look at to break that tie? When they have the same number of oxygens, then you say the more electronegative the nonmetal, the more acidic. So again, first when comparing oxyacids, you look at oxygen. If they have different numbers of oxygen, then simply the one with more oxygen will be stronger. If they have the same number of oxygens, then all you're gonna say now is, whichever one has the more electronegative nonmetal would be more acidic. And remember, when it comes to electronegativity, it increases going from left to right, but it decreases going down a group.